Guys.
It's nice to talk to you again.
For Herbert Chapman.
We're looking for Herbert Chapman. I'm Tom CSD Marks. He's dead, bro.
He's definitely not here. I've been banging on his door off and on for a couple of hours. Yeah. He's out somewhere.
Probably burning houses.
Let's take a look at the car.
Yeah, that might be good. Just leave these things unlocked.
Let's see what he's hauling around.
I got one thing immediately. I mean, that's a lot very of, suspicious.
Yeah, a lot of suspicious things.
Motive, opportunity, and hard evidence.
What's his motive or opportunity?
Well, because he was a person of interest in a previous case.
What did he do in a previous case?
50 ammo.
Does he have exactly 7 shots? Hold on. He's 8 shots.
One in the chamber. 7 in the mag.
9-11's hold 6 in the chamber, 1 in the mag.
That no. No, they don't.
Build 7 total.
No, it's 7 plus 1.
I think there's 6 plus 1.
No, there's 7 plus
Google
1.
Google it.
How much?
I demand question. Satisfaction.
How much money do you want to bet? How much you betting? It's Chapman. He's coming out of the laundry.
25 cents. I'm going big on it.
Ooh, deal.
Cops. Again.
This guy just shoot at us. Okay, why did you just get on the train and not take out the gun?
Son of a bitch. He must have caught the trolley. We got to move fast, Cole.
I mean, I would love to move fast.
I'll call this in. Get some cars dispatched.
I mean, we know he can't get too
Car
far.
11K calling KGPL.
He hijacked a trolley?
11K requesting assistance.
We need help. There's a trolley.
I mean, there's nothing we can do about it.
Yeah. Feeds us some 7-round detachable box, standard box magazine.
Since when?
Since 1911.
I could have sworn I was right about that.
No, it's 7 plus 1.
They won't let me get ahead of it. Seriously. Hey, well, there you go. He apparently just bought that gun.
I don't think we're in danger.
Okay. That's the end of this chapter.
Hang on. Herschel, I don't think we're in danger of losing this trolley that's on a track.
See if he can damage one of the wheels. Might have to break and slow the thing down.
I'm going to do that. It's made of train stuff. It wasn't my wheel. Okay.
As soon as he ditches the tram, we'll be there to grab him.
Yeah, I mean, it's really...
You gotta get me closer. Look, Cole, the side plate's gone. Get me closer. I think I got a shot here.
I mean, you should. You have like.
Probably
yeah.
Shoot the air brake, yeah. Oh, okay. No!
End of the line, you little prick. Come on, Cole.
Well, I'll just head right to the door here.
Ah, shoot.
Anyway, guys, that was my idea last episode about that G4 thing. I'm sure we'll get a lot of. What are you, an idiot? Enough. I probably wasn't supposed to kill him.
Like we have our man, Cole. Well done.
I'm not so sure. Chapman seemed to have his own agenda. Seems to be more to this than a personal vendetta.
I got real in trouble there.
Yeah, we almost got...
Yeah, I was like, I guess I gotta kill him.
See Chapman and my bro working together.
You have a point. The evidence is good for Chapman.
You guys lost both your hats.
Yeah, it was exciting. Yeah, that's true. McCole's a justice man.
Nice work, gentlemen.
That's the end of that chapter,
yourself,
isn't it?
Considerable risk stopping that trolley and probably saved a lot of lives. Anyone else but you, Phelps, and you'd be up for a bravery award. We've had our eyes on that slippery son of a bitch Chapman for as long as I can remember.
He's recording in a booth.
I couldn't be happier than to wipe him off the scoreboard. I hope this puts to bed that crazy stuff you had going about Leland Monroe.
It's like he's remembering it in a dream.
Yeah.
Like the little echo.
Calling Richard Nixon a crook next.
That soon to be president.
Boy, I wonder if this guy knows. In 27 years,
he'll be famously known as a crook. It's a little anachronism.
Despite denying that he is one.
Oh, she's happy. Cole's happy.
It's true.
What is it?
A letter from Lou. His insurance policy named me beneficiary.
I will say, guys.
Who's Lou?
Who's Lou? The one guy that you knew who died of like a heroin overdose.
Oh, yeah.
It's a very generous settlement. Elsa.
See, back in the 40s, even druggies had life insurance policies.
What has that got to do with Lou?
Nothing.
I want you to reject this settlement.
What?
I want you to go and see an investigator named Jack Kelso and ask him to make some inquiries about Lou's case.
Isn't this...
Guys, I will say very much... if you want to know who was a very handsome man as a young, very handsome young man, it was Richard P. Nixon.
Really?
Very handsome. That's a handsome man.
That's a mean looking guy.
I think he's very handsome as a younger man.
He looks like that one guy who was in Gone in 60 Seconds. He was Sphinx in that movie.
Yeah, I don't know.
No, he wasn't Sphinx. Sorry. He was the British guy.
Yeah, I still don't know.
Yeah, whatever. Looks a lot like him. He might. It might have been Sphinx. Google Sphinx from Gone in 60 Seconds real quick, please. I'm worried that might be Angelina Jolie's character. Which, if I'm wrong, you'll get a very nice picture of her with dreadlocks.
Well?
I know, we nailed that.
Yeah, we really did.
Well, I guess that's the end of that chapter.
Yeah, I think we still have to take him in dead.
House of Sticks! Oh, Jack Kelso works here?
Yeah.
I didn't realize that.
Mr. Kelso? The Sphinx. It was Vinnie Jones.
Do you have a picture?
Not a great one.
Can I see this not great picture?
There we go. That's a better one. You're thinking he looks like that guy? I'm not super convinced.
Oh, yeah, absolutely that guy.
Maybe a little bit.
Thank you.
Dear Mrs.
$20K back in 1947.
No, that's a ton of money.
Tonzo. The check's already made out, bro.
There's no need to come to the office, Ms. Lichtman. If you accept the settlement, all you need to do is sign here.
Well?
I don't accept the
What
settlement.
Do you mean you don't accept? I think you're pushing your luck, lady. Seems to be a ridiculously generous settlement. A $200 policy with a $20,000 payout? You should...
I don't want the money.
What do you mean you don't want the money?
I want you to investigate this case. I feel my friend may have been the victim of foul play.
Oh, shit. Did we flip the Jack Kelso switch?
Pretty confident we did.
Oh, nice!
So that was a heck of a thing there.
Well, I missed it. Sorry. I was too busy being excited that we're playing as Jack Kelso.
It's just, that would be a very strange demeanor for Jack Hills to have. What am I possibly looking at?
We're looking at his case. So.
Okay.
There's got to be more in these files.
So I think I just go to this other page, scroll down a little bit. Because insurance is against loss or damage not exceeding $900.
There we go.
Working collapse. It's like 8:30 in the morning. It's pretty close.
Sounds like your friend took a hell of a fall. I'm sorry for your loss.
I just mean, like, he was, like, real blunt. I don't know if that's how a person in this position would be. He was like, lady, it's great. Whatever.
I mean, possibly.
But it's not suspicious or anything. I think we're done here.
Do you mind if I ask you a couple of questions?
I also draw pictures.
We had to take sketching in Marine camp.
You, Buck Walter, was a craftsman. I don't believe you.
Okay, so here's the deal about this. I know, as a human, me, Tom C., I know that she is being sent here for different reasons.
Right.
I do not believe I have any proof for her coming in here. I want to say this is a doubt. This seems like a ridiculous reason to...
Hang on, let me think really hard about it.
Yeah, I think it's absolutely a doubt.
Thinking really hard? Yeah, it's a doubt. Good call.
You want me to reopen this case based on your
wants? Yeah, seriously.
That isn't going to happen. Take the money.
I've already told you I do not want the money. There's something wrong with that house.
Okay. It's haunted.
Collection of Buckwalter.
Buckwalter weren't married?
No.
And how did you become his beneficiary?
We were family friends.
Doubt. Doubt, ding, doubt, ding, doubt, ding. Doubt, doubt. Unless I have something proving that's not the case.
Nah.
You expect me to reopen this case because you come in here walking that walk?
And talking that talk?
I think you should tell me what the hell is going on.
Yeah, for real.
You really want to know?
Yes.
Yeah, idiot.
We were interned together on Ellis Island.
There's internment at Ellis Island?
Yeah. It was interned for people who weren't allowed in the country yet. It wasn't Japanese American internment.
Still, 4 years is pretty good.
So the roof collapsed. Accidents happened. What exactly are you trying to achieve here, Ms. Lichtman?
He's mad.
Exactly what I said. I want that building thoroughly investigated.
Truth.
It looks pretty truthful.
I'm intrigued, Ms. Lichtman. I really am. But you're going to have to give me something.
Talking about naked pictures.
Surrounding Elysian Fields and the new houses they are building. I believe your insurance company is involved.
Jack Kelso wasn't informed, so now he's interested. Got it. Cole Phelps is a smart man.
I've told you what I know, Mr. Kelso. What are you going to do about it?
Probably take lunch.
One final question.
How big are them? Titties.
Yes.
What's your address?
Is that the usual?
Is there anything usual about this case, Ms. Lichtman?
The address is on the letter, Mr. Kelso.
Oh, snap.
The address. Not the phone number.
Boy, him and Cole Phelps are from the same cloth. I always wonder about those arm bands.
Which ones?
You see on his suit, he has like... Right
oh,
there.
Yeah, yeah.
It's very old school.
Well, here's what I think that is. I believe that's...
Both Buttmans. See, his man out there.
Mr. Benson would like to see you in his office, Jack.
I need to stick my head in front of this lady's butt. Thank you.
He
here's
heard
what I think
this
it
already?
Is. I think that at a time when shirts... I don't know.
If this was Metal Gear Solid 2, this one would be a robot, and with a giant shootout would start.
Yeah.
Because they know the jig's up. Like, ba-dum-bum,
I think it's for when you buy sleeves that are too big, that are too long for you. I think if you like cuff them and then like have those armbands up, it keeps them from like.
Are you trying to imply there's no tailors back in 1940?
I'm trying to imply that maybe Jack Kelso can't afford a tailor, but he can afford sweet armbands.
You wanted to see me? Oh yes, Jack. I'm just trying out a new putter. I know.
Would you kindly get hit by it?
It's the weirdest thing, Mr. Benson. Call me Curtis, Jack. This is California.
Like I said, we're crazy Curtis, here.
This is a very strange case.
That's a very strange suit you're wearing.
Jack, that lady Elsa Lichtman is refusing a 20 grand payout.
How does he know her?
Elsa Lichtman is hardly a lady, Jack. She's a jazz musician. Plays at the Blue Room in Hollywood.
Sealed up her vagina tight. She's played that jazz. Now that
I think she's the beneficiary of this guy, Lou Buckwalter. He was killed in an industrial accident working for Elysian Fields Developments. You know Elysian?
I'm familiar with Leland Monroe. We move in similar circles.
Just so you know, I'm also very important.
Well, Ms. Lichtman is making some pretty serious action.
If you have a fireplace in your office, that's pretty good.
She's a very highly strung girl, Jack. Strung out might be a better way to put it.
Oh, my gosh.
It's a pretty generous payment, Curtis. I think I should look into it.
Is there anything wrong with the paperwork, Kelso?
No, there isn't, Mr. Benson.
I didn't think so. Pay the case out and get her off our backs.
I can't make her take the money,
Deal
sir.
With it, Jack. Do your fucking job.
Oh, boy. God, that's composure
do I
quick.
Do have to do everything?
No, sir, you don't.
Fine, Jack. Fine. You know I have the greatest confidence in you.
I'm confident you will not do this thing that you don't have to do.
Thanks, Mr.
I'm confident that you will not investigate that any further. You do not seem like a man of integrity at all.
Now, one thing I know about you is you have no follow-through and you're willing to just do whatever I say.
No spine on you. That's why you were hired at this company.
We only hire spineless Marines. Oh, we have... Skip to my destination.
Yeah, he gets auto skip because he doesn't have drivers.
What, some kind of effing casual?
You like this Chevrolet Fleetmaster Tudor?
The word fleet was thrown around a lot more back in those days. Well, they liked boats more, I think.
Well, yeah, I was about to say, I think everyone was getting off the military kick. So they're like,
yeah, true.
Gotta have more things.
What could be more luxurious than a fleet? Excuse me, you crazy driver.
when an insane person slightly taps another driver.
Trying to hit another lane. Oh, I just missed it. This is a hard thing to do, but I'm doing it.
I don't know what you're doing.
You gotta hit only the blue mailboxes. I'm not crazy.
Wait for it. Oh, that wasn't as good as I wanted.
If it knocks over that fence, I'll be happy. Oh, it died. All right, good work, though. It's a nice car. Why do I have any ability to commandeer anything, by the way?
I don't
have a police siren. That's good.
I mean, that makes sense. You're not police.
Yeah, so I theoretically can't take any cars.
I mean, you could probably just be like, Jack Kelso, I need your car. And they'll be all like, all right. You seem like a trustworthy enough guy.
That's true.
Oh, that was a bad hit.
That one.
That was real bad.
Oh, knocked me up pretty good.
Oh my God, he's got the steel chair.
By God. Oops, I found it. Well, the car's definitely screwed. Hello? I'm interested in policing you. It's a Lou Bega died in a fire.
I like the little kitchenette.
Yeah, that's cool. It's like Fallout kitchenette.
Remember how good Fallout New Vegas is?
Yeah, I want to play it, dude. We could just play 5 episodes of that. And then that would be it. But that would make everyone happy. Frank Osterman?
That's not how my pop taught me to mix it. Someone is cutting corners.
I'm glad he said that because I would have no idea.
Yeah, I'm just like, okay.
There's a lot of ladies in here. Can I investigate those? That is an especially lewd... It's not even a calendar. Just popped it up.
They might have been photo or calendars.
It was at some point.
Well, no. Because, like, sometimes they would just do, like, pinup things where, like, the, like, if you had a poster, like, this big, like, the date grid would be, like, this big in, like, a small corner.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, you can't see it. But there's a very large disparity between the two sizes I'm making here. Order of Demolition.
Yeah.
Also, whatever this is, delays will not be tolerated. That's a pretty big memo.
What led to that one?
Boss, there might be some delays. Delays will not be tolerated.
Okay, great. Boy, maybe you don't put that up. That's definitely a clue. Can we look at how that's a clue? You're allowing me to look at it, but it's not, like, qualifying as a clue. Yes, please remember that. It's important. All right, well, there's that.
Hey, you just can't be walking around down here.
I'm Jack Kelso from California Fire and Life.
I don't care if you're from the Vatican. Buzz off.
I'm investigating the accidental death of a Lou Buckwalter. And
you deaf? Do I have to beat on
Excuse
you?
Excuse me?
Hey, I'm a goon.
You're a real asshole making me start this fight with you.
Ooh.
That was a good gutty punch.
Sucker punch.
I came
Ooh.
To see the house where Lou Buckwalter died. You were just about to offer to show me the way.
It's out the gate and 3 houses down to the left. Don't know what you're looking for, smart
guy. It would have explained if you didn't punch me, idiot. There.
Then I'll poke around in the rubble.
Fine. As long as you're out of my sight.
I'll get beaten up by you again if I have to. All right, 3rd house on the left. I'm guessing that's
this. Demolished house.
Okay.
Out past the gate. Maybe it's a car situation.
The car is indicating for me to go look at it. The car.
Come on. Oh, no. I should do Knight Rider. Come along, Jack. We must investigate.
Oh, luckily that's the location.
Oh, it was this one.
I probably could have walked.
You really did a shitty job demolishing this house, by the way.
It's like a fat girl sat on it.
Whoa, you can't say that.
It just looked like somebody sat on it. Let me rephrase that. Okay. Not for construction use. What an odd thing.
That's interesting that would be on there. You look
at this clown. How come he doesn't write these things down?
He's got a really good memory.
That's a brick. She's a brick and I'm burning, burning. Remember that song? It's a yes. Huge hit for no good reason.
They go back out front. I think there might have been some other evidence that you might have missed towards one of the other flags.
Okay, we saw that. Probably this one.
No, that was apparently the one we already... I hope that was the one we already saw.
No, that was actually not the one we already saw. Hello? Look at it, dude.
No, but really, ding ding. There we go.
What's the problem, man? Are you serious? Oh, God. Stone films.
Who gets their lumber from a film studio?
That's not the sound I wanted to hear. Excuse me? There's a lot of reasons why this isn't going to work. Really? Shoot at him. How am I going to do that?
Jack also was a graduate of the Prometheus School running away from things.
Yeah, let's just climb up. Go, go, go. Stop doing it. Are you serious? Okay, he would not stop aiming. I swear to God, dude.
We've apparently been having trouble with this before.
Yeah, I'm just going to run from this. I really don't see any reason to not just run. Okay, he really caught up to me fast on this one. It seemed outrageous, but...
Yeah, I think we have to wait for him to put the thing down. Because I think he puts it up after he clears rubble.
He's like absurdly fast all of a sudden.
Well, he started bearing down on us really quick.
He's like right on it. Are we serious with this?
Well, maybe you gotta do it now. Oh, because he raises it up, but it slows it down.
Okay. Stop aiming, dude. Are you serious?
Get off the thing.
Yeah. Do you think you heard me press every button? That was outrageous, dude.
That was pretty ridiculous.
I'm like, clearly. Son of a bitch. Okay. That was a lot of fun. This is stupid. I want everyone to know that. I am willing to skip this, but I'm going to do it.
Okay. They really just start you off too close.
Okay, let's try this again.
Here we go. 18th time's the charm. Now that's a reasonable distance to start from.
There we go. I'm just going to give it a good running start here.
Nope, I don't think you're running start enough.
Yeah, you would be dead. Okay. One more try. Here we go. Wonder if I lose points for skipping.
It just said your progress will not, or your something will not be affected.
If my something was affected.
All right, now aim it at him now, because I'll slow him down.
That one slowed him a little bit. Go! What the? That was like, it's like ridiculously like effed up. He's like not that close, and then he is that close.
It's like Resident. It's like the worst Resident Evil aiming.
Yeah, this is terrible. Okay. Why are you so stupid? Is he dead? What are you? This is like inappropriate for this game.
Yeah, that seemed really dumb.
That was like, that was the worst thing in this game. Just like, period.
And then he does not follow up and investigate at all. Just be like, hey.
Can I use your phone?
Remember that time you almost tried to kill me with a fucking bulldozer, you insane man?
Yeah. An idiot. This
Look at these two jive cats.
Just jump, mom. What?
That price is outrageous. Jack okay. Kelso, California Fire and Life Investigator.
Today I was at Wawa, and I was using the soda machine. There was a girl at the Slurpee machine. She looked directly at me.
Did she slurp at that day?
No, she said, I said, what?
No, thank you, ma'am.
She went, oh, I wasn't talking to you. And there's no one else around. It was the weirdest thing in the world.
Maybe she's just talking to herself.
She's crazy.
Guys, I'm talking to you about seeing you on the next 20 episodes.
Wow. Yeah. See you, folks.
Touching butts.
Love.